Greetings, all praise King Selassie. Jah Rastafari. What is gay? What do gay people look like? How do gay people act? If someone has a child and they act gay, what is that? Is that universal throughout history? Or are they subject to external manipulation? Are they possessed? This is strong language. And yet there are explanations. But first you must interpret what it means by being gay. If you go to one of those marches, you see all kinds of people, some dressed as the opposite sex, some not, some you wouldn't know. So someone's child is acting gay, does that really mean they are gay? Or does that mean you have been conditioned to believe they are acting gay? Yes, all praising King Selassie. Talking to someone, I was being told that gay is natural. And the reasoning was that there had been development in a child that appeared to be feminine. Now let's examine this. The definition of gay, in my view, is someone that is attracted to the same sex. Does that necessarily come with a cover? If you go to a gay pride march, does everyone look the same? Do they act the same? So what does it mean to act gay? If a child is acting gay, does that mean they are attracted to the same sex? Are they going to be accepted equally within a society that values traditional marriage? So there's an external influence that plays a role in conditioning a person and is highly influential in the early processes of development. And this is able to be manipulated. Today, values have changed. What was forbidden is accepted and glorified. Yet is it natural? That is the defining question of whether it is right or wrong. And again, to use the example of someone acts gay, so they must be, is flawed, because there are people that may act gay and not be. However, they will be interpreted by those in the environment as being gay and thus treated such, which may push them in that arena. This is a process of conditioning. It is not natural. Yes, if one becomes accustomed to a particular culture, they will be subject to that cultural standard. And yet, if the cultural standard becomes flawed, there is a balance needed, and therefore the person may become separate, because the culture is no longer following a natural path. This does not make one to be at fault, yet the standard that is upheld. Could we have an honest discussion? The people that promote this lifestyle are in hiding. You know, there was an ongoing campaign to introduce the rest of the world to this lifestyle, and now it has, for the most part, ceased. The agenda is to get all to accept, and those that do not are trouble. Yet even those that do know it's not right.